And then moment of truth. Hello everyone and welcome to Maker's Movement. I am out here at somewhere near the mile 40 marker of the Smith River in Montana. And today we're gonna do a review. More of a comparison really of fire steels. So I have a couple of different fire steels, one from Ferro Fire and one from Bayite, and we're gonna do a little comparison on them. Now, I expect that they're probably gonna be fairly similar because they are just ferrocerium, but let's talk about that. Now, what I have here is, I have this fire steel from Ferro Fire and this one from Bayite. The first thing you'll notice is that they're both really, real similar. It's a ferro rod, they both have a cord wrap handle, and they both come with a striker attached to the end, which is a preference of mine. You know, I have ferro rods, I keep them on my knives. But as you know, with a knife, you generally have to do some modifications to the back of the blade. You have to straighten it up and get a nice 90 degree cut. And sometimes, while that's great for allowing you to scrape a ferro rod, it's not so great when you have to do a lot of heavy work with your knife. So rather than modify my blades, I prefer to just get a ferro rod that comes with a striker on it. So that's the way we're gonna look at these. I ordered these two both off of Amazon. I'll link to both of them below, and you can decide which one is right for you. Now first, let's understand what we're dealing with here with the ferrocerium rod. It is, a lot of people mistakenly call it a fire steel or a flint and steel, when it's neither of those things. This is a metal that's commonly referred to as mish metal. Now, I don't know all the components that go into it, into the alloy, but it is definitely an alloy. It's a combination of metals. It's not anything that occurs naturally like a flint. The metal itself is mixed up and it's extruded into these tubular shapes. And then the size of the tube is really dependent on its use. So I have these here. These I also buy from Ferro Fire. So I'm very familiar with their product. Now, when you get these, there's two different kinds that you might see. There's a softer one and a harder one. Now, I personally prefer the softer one. I think that you can get better sparks off of it because it throws more of a big gob of sparks. And also, if you're very gingerly with your scraping, you can actually scrape off curls and use it very much like you would use a magnesium block. So you can use that as an extra amount of accelerant to light your tinder. The first thing we'll look at is we'll look at the size. So they're both 4 inches, but we can see that there's a pretty significant difference here in the diameter of it. Now, I don't think that makes a huge difference. Really, if weight is a classification for you, then you might want to go with a smaller one. But if weight's not an issue, or if you're putting it in a survival kit and something that's, you know, going to be stowed away in a vehicle or a boat, or, you know, in our case, like on our rubber rafts, then you definitely want something that's going to be a little beefier, because after you start using it, they can erode if they get water on them and stuff, especially salt water. They're very corrosive. So for starters, I just want to kind of look over these and decide which one I want to buy more of. That's the thing, because I've already got these two. Now, one thing to consider would be initially the size. They're probably both pretty comparable when it comes to function. But which one of these handle colors is gonna suit you best? For me, I like the orange, but I like it not because it's cool or tactical, but because it's probably gonna be easier to find than the green one. I can see right there. You can't see the green one at that distance, and I'll be lucky if I find it now, to tell you the truth, but let me go see if I can find it. So you can see there's a definite advantage to the Ferro Fire version when it comes to finding it in the wilderness. Now, if you want everything to be tactical, then I get it. I don't necessarily. My tactical days are behind me, and I'm more concerned with having equipment that if I set it down somewhere and lose it or walk away, I can walk back and find it. So orange is your friend here. So the two factors so far is the girth of it. How long do you want it to last? This is probably gonna last twice as long as this. Even in a harsh environment like seawater and salt, lanyards will give you roughly the same amount of 550 cord. And then we have the strikers. Now, everybody's familiar with this. Simple plastic striker. It's very easy to handle. It's very easy to use. There's plenty of line here, so you got plenty of reach. You don't have to worry about the line being too short. Those same functions are happening here as well. So there's not a lot of differences there to compare except the striker. Now, I'm familiar with Ferro Fire's strikers and I find them to be really, really stellar. It says on the package that their logo is a sort of a grip enhancer. And I thought that sounded like a lot of bull to me, but if you grab the two, you could see that there's definitely an amount of grip that it provides over this. I'm actually squeezing much harder with this hand and it's still coming out real easy. And this one's not moving at all. So it actually does work. It actually provides them a little bit of grip with their logo there, which was surprising to me. But the key thing is, how do they strike? So we'll start with a Bayite. It's easy enough to hold it on the wrap. Maybe put your thumb or whatever, just a couple of fingers to hold it. It's gonna take a couple of strikes because that black is an oxidation and you gotta kinda get through that and get to the metal on the other side, so. So that throws pretty good sparks. And then we'll see how the Ferro Fire goes. So it started sparking really quick. Now it might look roughly the same to you, but believe me, that Ferro Fire was throwing them a lot farther, so they're a little harder to see. The other thing I like about this striker right here is it's got those little teeth. So those teeth are really handy for working on the inside of bark or whatever to reduce your tinder down to something really fuzzy and with some friction. Is it gonna always work on all materials? Absolutely not, but it's nice to just have that little extra piece. Plus you have four striking edges. You would have the same here, four striking edges. But this lacks the beefy control, so in cold weather, I'd probably prefer something like this with a little bit more to hold on to. I think for striker, this wins. Obviously, this wins for girth. Obviously, this wins for orange, so it's looking pretty good for the Ferro Fire one right now. And they both throw about the same amount of sparks, although this scraper seems to dig in more. I can feel that it's kind of getting a little bit more purchase on there. The next thing I'll do is make up a couple of fuzz sticks and we'll see if we can't get a fire started with one or both of these two with nothing more than a little bit of wood shaved down into curls. I don't think they like me in their camp. Now I got a couple of fuzz sticks here. The goal is to get each of these ferro rods to start the fuzz stick, and that should be a really good indicator about the level and the strength of the sparks that it's throwing out. I got a little extra fuel here. And on this one, we'll start with the Ferro Fire. I'm gonna try and scrape off some curls. It does a very good job at just leaving a little bit of curls without actually making a spark. It's a nice function using this as a rake. And then moment of truth. Now I got a lot of wind here, but it did work. It did get me going. All right. One spark and I got flame. See how we do with the Bayite. So I can tell you, I can feel that this one's a slightly harder than this. Like I said, there's a couple of different classes of hardness and I like the softer ones myself, but you can see what happens. I'm trying to do slow and just get curls, so we'll try that again. I'll do it a little bit slower. And then we'll put this down. We'll see what we get. And that one also burned. And there you go. I don't know that you can go wrong with either one of the two. Really, it comes down to what do you like. Do you like a big striker or a small striker? Do you like orange or do you like green? And do you like a fatter rod or a lighter rod? Those are really what it comes down to. For me, the clear winner is this one. Like I said, I'm 40 miles down the Smith River in Montana, and I will not be home for days. There's value in that. Okay, I can find that one. I can't find a green one. And that matters to me, especially if I'm in a situation that's a little bit high stress, like a survival situation, or like trying to use it to make fire in something like a rainstorm, which I have moving in on me right now. It's been raining this entire trip. So in order to start a fire and then rush around and get your firewood and get everything together, and then by the time you're done, you don't know where you set your fire steel. There have been people on shows that have quit for less. So, you know, choose your tools wisely. The little things are what makes a big difference out in the backcountry. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you on the next one.